Hello and welcome to showmeacademy.com. In this tutorial, we're going to show you how to create pivot tables in Microsoft Excel 2007. First of all, let me just give you a brief explanation as to what a pivot table is and why you would want to use one. Oftentimes, when you see a table of data in Excel, that data has already had a lot of aggregate values associated with it. It's been added, it's been subtracted, it's been divided, so that what you're seeing is a more refined set of data. But what if you have a series of rows? It might be hundreds of rows, it might be thousands of rows of just individual pieces of information that have to be summed and aggregated and reported upon. For example, here you can see that this is a bunch of NFL data that talks about the offensive statistics from the recently finished NFL season. But what if I had a huge table that had on every row, every play, and the result of every play from every team throughout the year? Well, we could actually use pivot tables to pull a report like the one that we see here that would allow us to report on the aggregate number of points for the season, the aggregate number of yards for the season. It would be segmented by team, etc. And that would allow us to build interactive reports based upon the data that we had in the spreadsheet. Let me make that a little more real for you by giving you a harder example. For example, in this spreadsheet here, I've been tracking the results of a diet over the course of several months. And each day I show the aggregate amount of weight that I've lost or gained. And then I have the day of the week behind it. And the reason I listed the day of the week is because I then want to be able to look at that data and determine if there are certain days of the week when I do better or worse on that diet. Now, there's a couple different ways that we can try to figure that out. One is that I could sit here with a calculator and say, well, on the first Tuesday I gain zero, and on the next Tuesday I gain 1.8, and the next Tuesday I gain 1.4, and then et cetera, et cetera. And I could try to add all this stuff together, which of course is slow and painful and inefficient. Luckily, there's a way with pivot tables for it to automatically calculate these values for you. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all the data that I want to report on. So in this case, I'm going to do this, and then I'm going to go to the insert tab up here, and on the left side of the insert tab under the tables section, you can see there's this option here for pivot table. And when I click on that, it's going to ask me for the range of data that I want to use for this pivot table. Now in this case, it already has the proper range selected because I selected those cells before I even began the pivot table operation. So in this case, I can just click OK. When I do that, it actually creates a brand new sheet. You see, I have sheet 1 over here, which has all of my original data. And sheet 11, in this case, is where we're going to create our new pivot table. And you'll notice over here that we have these options here for fields that we want to report on. None of them are checked by default. But if I check both of these and say I want to report on the change, notice as soon as I do that, it gives me the aggregate change for all the numbers. So in aggregate, I've lost 16 pounds. And then when I add this one, now it gives me the aggregate change by day. So it summed up all the values for Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, and Thursday. And if I were to uncheck now change and just show day, it just gives me a list of every day that we had as an option. But if I check that back again, now it gives me the aggregate sum of results by day. And if you don't like the order in which these come, you can come over here and you can select this like this and just drag it up to a better place. So now we have the regular order of Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And this gives us some more powerful data because we can start to drill into it and see that, well, clearly Sundays have not been very good days for the diet. Wednesdays have been great days, Friday's pretty good, etc., etc. This helps us to pull reports based upon the data that we already had without doing a lot of manual calculations. Let me give you another example of how this can be used. I have this spreadsheet here that I use for tracking finances, and you can see that each line item in the spreadsheet is a record of an individual expense. However, I want to have some more powerful reporting that shows me how much spending I'm doing on a monthly basis, how much spending I'm doing per category, etc. So I can go through here and I can select all this data. And then I'm going to go to Insert, Pivot Table. And again, it has this data selected because that's what I'd selected before I started the process. I click OK and it creates my new sheet. Notice all these categories that we have over here that were based upon the data that we selected. So I'll say that I want to report by month. And I want to report by category because I want to see what I'm spending per category. And I also want to report on how much I'm spending per category. So I'm going to need the month, the category, and the total. And now you can see I have these values here for February. It shows you by category how much I've been spending in each particular area. And as I add more values to it, if I were to add values for March or April or May, those will also get built into the spreadsheet, into the pivot table in such a way that they get broken out first by month, then by category, and then summed in an aggregate fashion. So you can see that pivot table can be a very powerful means by which we can determine in much better fashion what the underlying data means. We can pull reports. We can sort items by category and by total and by month, etc. Becomes a much better way for us to manipulate data. That concludes this tutorial. Thank you for using showmeacademy.com.